The United States military largest counterterrorism exercise on the African continent is wrapping up Friday. The two-week U.S.-led event brings together 2,000 military personnel from more than 30 African and Western nations. Our VOA Pentagon correspondent Carla Babb is in Camp Zagre on the edge of Burkina Faso's capital Ouagadougou, where she has taken an inside look into these counter-terror operations.
Yes, this week we've seen how African nations and Western nations have worked together to share tactical skills, how to secure a perimeter, how to provide medical assistance to people who've been hurt, and we've also seen how they've shared operational command insight. This training in Burkina Faso comes as the country is battling an insurgency of several Al-Qaeda-linked groups. I spoke to one Burkinabe officer, and he told me the insurgency was like a toxin to his country. The U.S. ambassador to Burkina Faso, Andrew Young, told VOA that the situation, the threat was getting worse. And I spoke with Major General Marcus Hicks. He's the commander of Special Operations Forces on the continent. And he was very frank about the counter-terror war in West Africa.
I would tell you at this time, we are not winning. You know, the larger group of Western liberal democracies and those who seek to be democracies and struggle with the transition to democracy and aspire to be democracies are not winning against the Salafist threat.
And all this as the Pentagon has announced that they are cutting military personnel on the continent by 10%. The first round of those cuts have already happened. They cut between 100 and 200 military personnel from West Africa. Major General Hicks says he would not recommend cutting troops further.
Well, thank you very much, Carla. That's VOA Pentagon correspondent Carla Babb reporting from Ouagadougou.